Hello students, welcome to our maths class. So continuation of lines and angles, of course lengthy chapter, and that too it is a geometry topic, so we can't go fast by applying the formulas and all. So understanding the diagram, and it is taking some time, so I will teach slowly only, no problem. So students, in this lines and angles chapter, we are in there are four exercises. Now we are in the third exercise, and already six problems we completed. All of you look at the seventh problem, read and understand the seventh problem, seventh question. Seventh one: in the diagram A parallel to B, C parallel to D, and the name the angles that are congruent to angle 1, angle 2. See students, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So 16 angles are there. Name the angles congruent to 1. Congruent to 1. Congruent means similar and equal. Congruent means, the definition of congruence is similar and equal. So here we take it as equal. In this case we take it as equal. So angle 1 is here, no? So which other angle is equal to 1? Which other angle is equal to 1, you have to tell. I gave all the concepts. Corresponding angles are equal. Internal alternate angles are equal. Interior alternate angles are equal if lines are parallel. If lines are parallel, corresponding angles are equal. Interior alternate angles are equal. Exterior alternate angles are equal. I gave all these definitions and concepts. So see this figure, and which is equal to angle 1? Angle 1 is equal to what? See students, angle 1 is equal to angle 3. What is the reason? Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Vertically opposite angles. If two lines intersect, these two alternate vertically opposite angles are equal. So angle 1 is equal to angle 3. So vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. 1 is equal to 3. Vertically opposite angles. Next students, 1 is also equal to 5. 1 is equal to 5. These two are parallel lines. Of course, these also parallel lines. These two are parallel. This is a transversal. This is one exterior angle, one interior angle on the same side of the transversal. These are corresponding angles. 1 and 5 are corresponding angles. 1 and 5 are equal, students. 1 is equal to 5. 5 is equal to 7. 5 is equal to 7. Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Next students, 1 is also equal to 9 because these two are corresponding angles, because these two are parallel. This is a transversal, this is a transversal, these two are parallel lines, parallel lines. This is a transversal, these two are corresponding angles. 1 is exterior, 1 is interior, same side of the transversal. 1 is equal to 9, corresponding angles. 1 is equal to 9 is equal to 11. Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. 9 is equal to 11. Vertically opposite angles. Next. 9 is equal to 11. 9 is equal to 13 corresponding angles. 9 is equal to 13 corresponding angles. Two lines are parallel. This is the transversal. Same side of the transversal. One is exterior, one is interior. 9 is equal to 13. 13 is equal to 15. What are the reasons, students? Why 13 is equal to 15? Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. So therefore, angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Next, 1 is also equal to 5. 5 is equal to 7. 1 is also equal to 9. 9 is equal to 11. 11 and 9 is also equal to 13. 13 is equal to 15. So 1 is equal to 3 is equal to 5 is equal to 7 is equal to 9, 11, 13, 15. All are equal angles. Different reasons. If two lines are intersecting, vertically opposite angles are equal. So corresponding angles are equal. Like that, all. See, we can call these two as alternate angles also. 3 is equal to 5, alternate angles. Like that. So many reasons we can explain. So, but anyway, all these 1 is equal to 3 and 1 is also equal to 5 means 1 is equal to 3, 3 is equal to 5, 5 is equal to 7, 7 and 1 is also equal to 9, 9 is equal to 11, 11 is equal to 9 is also equal to 13, so 11 is equal to 13 is equal to 15, like that. All are equal. All are equal. Next, congruent to 2. Which angle is equal to 2? That also we have to do. First, you understand this concept. You copy afterwards also. Students, now, congruent to 2, congruent to 2, which angle is, which of these angles, total 16 angles, no? So, which angles are equal to 2, that you have to tell. Sir, students, 2 is equal to 4. Why? 2 is equal to 4 vertically opposite angles. Angle 2 is equal to angle 4. 2 is equal to 4. See. Same reasons. 2 is equal to 4. Why 2 is equal to 4? Vertically opposite angles. Is equal to 4. Say 2 is equal to 6 also because corresponding angles. 2 is equal to 6 also. Or 4 is equal to 6 also. Alternate angles. Both are interior. One is this side, one is opposite. 4 and 6 are alternate angles. That also you can write, friends. Anyway, so many ways are there. Interior alternate angles. is equal to 4 vertically opposite angles, 4 is equal to 6 interior alternate angles, 6 is equal to 8 vertically opposite angles. Next, 6 is equal to 8 over. Also equal to 10, corresponding angles 2, 10. These two are parallels. This is exterior, this is interior. So one is exterior, one is exterior. Same side, 2 is equal to 10 corresponding angles. Is equal to 10. 10 is equal to 2 vertically opposite angles. 10 is equal to 12 vertically opposite angles. Interior alternate angles. 12 is equal to 14 interior alternate angles, 14 is equal to 16 vertically opposite. So therefore, angle 2 is equal to angle 4 is equal to 6 is equal to 8 is equal to 10 is equal to 12 is equal to 14 is equal to 16. All these angles are equal. So total chapter concept is there in this question. So what are the corresponding angles? What are the vertically opposite angles? What are the alternate angles? All the concepts are included here. So, and even not only this method, we can apply different methods to prove that 2 is equal to 4 is equal to 6 is equal to 8 is equal to 10 is equal to 12 is equal to 14 is equal to 16. Like that. So you practice. Very, very important model. Practice this. Students, you copy this problem. Now go to the eighth one. Students, eighth one. This is the figure, but of course it is in a different way, but I don't like this. Anyway is okay. So same, I don't like this. So same diagram, friends, no confusion. Same diagram I wrote. Now, in the figure, arrowhead segments are parallel. This is parallel to this. These two are parallel. In the given figure, arrowhead segments are parallel. Arrowhead segments are parallel. That means this is parallel to this. Carefully observe. observe that figure, students. Now I am saying that angle X is, angle Y is equal to angle 59. I am saying like this. What is the reason? Angle Y is equal to angle 59. What is the reason? You think of it. Directly I am saying that Y is equal to 59. What is the reason? You think of it. This is a parallel line. This is a parallel line. This is a transversal. Both interior, one is this side, one is another side. These two are called interior alternate angles. Interior alternate angles. Lot of practice you have to do. So Y is equal to 59. The reason is interior alternate angles. Y is equal to 59. Y is equal to 59. This is a line. See, I will explain like this. This is a line. This is a line. If you draw like this, these two are interior alternate angles. This is Y. This is 59. If it, there is a triangle, you may get confused. But if it is like this, easily you can tell. So, both are inside and opposite sides of the transversal. They are called interior alternate angles and they are equal. Y is equal to 59 over diagonal. Next, students, X is equal to how much? X is equal to how much? I will draw a different figure like this. First, I will draw in this line. This line and this line. This line also I am drawing. This is 60. This is Y. If total figure, if figure is like this, you may get a little confused because it is like a triangle. So, only this line and this line if you consider. These two are corresponding angles. Corresponding angles are, sorry, it is X. Corresponding angles are equal. See, two lines are parallel. If a line is cutting both of them at two points, that is called transversal. So, two angles on the same side of the transversal, one is exterior, one is interior, are called corresponding angles. So, also, angle X is equal to angle 60. Reason is corresponding angles. Over. So, angle Y is equal to 59 degrees, answer. Angle X is equal to 60 degrees, answer. Two questions, we got answers for both the questions. Right now. Copy it and write the ninth question, students. Ninth one. Ninth one. Ninth question. Draw the diagram. This is a figure. So you have to find X and Y. Find X value and Y value. See here. So many concepts are there. If you know all, what are the corresponding angles, what are the interior opposite angles, what are the exterior opposite angles, and what are the vertically opposite angles. If you know these four concepts, any method you can apply. There is no particular process. Any method you can apply to find x and y. What I am doing? An angle on the straight line is 180 degrees. That also you should know. So, see here, students. If this is 105, this will be also 105. Let us take it as, say, for example, z. I am taking this as z. I am introducing. It is not there in the question. Question is x 35, y 105. This, let us take it as, because it is empty, no, I will take it as z. I will take it as z. See here. In the given figure, angle z is equal to 105 degrees. This is equal to this. What is the reason? You decide. You think of it. Z is equal to 105, vertically opposite angles. Z is equal to 105. See, if two lines intersecting, this is z, this is 105. Both are equal because vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Z is equal to 105 over. But we have to find x and y. So z is 105. These two are equal. Now, see, I am writing 35 degrees plus angle z plus angle y. The sum is equal to 180 degrees. Students, what is the reason for this? You think of it. 35 plus z plus y, the sum is 180 degrees. What is the reason? 35, z, 105. This total is 180 because angle on the straight line. On a straight line, the total angle on one side of the straight line is 180. This side also 180. This total, this total is 180 degrees. Straight angle. Straight angle. 35 plus z is 105. Z is equal to 105. Plus angle y is equal to 180. 140. Over. Y is equal to 40 we got. X is equal to Y. I am writing X is equal to Y. You tell the reason, students. What is the reason for X is equal to Y? Why X and Y are equal? Think of it. This is line. This is line, parallel lines. It is given that both are parallel. So this is a transversal. These two are parallel. I will draw a separate line like this. See, this is a transversal. I am drawing this line. This is y. I am drawing this line. This is x. Now you tell why x and y are equal. Corresponding angles. Two lines are parallel. This is a transversal. So same side of the transversal, one is interior, one is exterior. They are corresponding angles. Angle x is equal to angle y. Corresponding angles. So y is 40, then x also 40. Y already got. So y 40 means x also 40. Over. We got y and x. So practice these problems.